Berlin is a dangerous place.
At least that's what many people think, especially from the countryside. But is it true? Is something dangerous only because it looks dangerous? Well, you're about to find out. In this video, I'm going to cover everything from how safe is Berlin for you as a person, how safe it is for your property outside and inside, and the general criminal activity around the city.
Are you ready?
Among all the cities in Germany, Berlin now is the most dangerous one. After years of being second place, we finally took the title from Frankfurt.
Yes!
That being said, Berlin is still a relatively safe city in a relatively safe country. I mean, it's still Germany. How dangerous can it be here? Well, if you believe the Global Peace Index here, we can see that Germany ranks in 23rd place, which isn't too bad at all. But it seems like exporting so many weapons is really ruining our score here. Let's see who's down there at the bottom. Iraq, Sudan, Russia? Ivan, how do you feel about Russia being almost last place, huh?
I think you misunderstand concept. In this game, you try to collect as many points as possible. Not as little as possible.
Right. But let's come back to Berlin. Berlin may be dangerous for German standards, but if we compare it internationally to other major cities, Berlin is still a super safe city to be in. For example, Berlin doesn't have any of those no-go areas, which are very common in big American cities. Here, you can go pretty much anywhere without having to worry too much. Nevertheless, Berlin has a few hotspots where the police has special rights and can search anyone being there without having a probable cause. That's because those areas have a higher criminal activity than other parts of the city. And here's a map with all those places. But just because there's a higher criminal activity going on, it doesn't necessarily mean it's more dangerous. They all made the list for very different reasons. Riga Straße, for example, is home to Berlin's leftist scene, whose hobby it is to burn Yuppie cars in the city. Görlitzer Park made it for all the drug dealers hanging out there. Neulendorfplatz because of the high amount of night muggings happening there. And Alexanderplatz and Hermannplatz made the list because of all the petty theft going on there. And now we have live connection to Cottbusser Tor, the place in Berlin with the highest concentration of shady people in all of Berlin. Ivan, how's things there?
It's crap as always. What do you think? I tell you one thing. If you come here, always bring Kalashnikov. I learned this first time I come here. First week Berlin, I come here, one guy come to me, not smell good, ask me money. I say, нет. He ask again, I say, нет. He said, you give me money or I put needle with weights in you. I look, I run. To get Kalashnikov. But when I come back, he not there anymore. But I learned lesson. If you come here, don't forget to bring Kalashnikov. Понимаешь?
Okay, thanks Ivan. Now, let's get to the juicy stuff, which is probably most important to you. Personal safety. Should you be afraid of murder, rape and muggings? The short answer is, not really. We'll have a look at the numbers for all of them, but let's start with murder. In 2020, the lives of 40 people have been taken in Berlin. Is that a lot? I don't know. Los Angeles, for example, which is a similar sized city, had 343. That's 900% higher than Berlin. Maybe I should cancel my trip to the US after all. You have to know that in Germany, it's pretty hard to get your hands on a gun. You can't just go in a shop and buy one. You have to go through months or sometimes even years of training. You have to take a psychological test to get one. So all the crazy people living here, they don't have guns. And in my humble opinion, that's a really nice thought to have.
Dude, is that a communist?
Jesus. Let's move on to rape. Not a nice topic to cover, but we should at least mention it here. In 2019, the city counted 871 rapes. That's about 23 per 100,000 people. That sounds like a lot, but if we have a look at London, for example, the number is 88 per 100,000 people.
That's four times as much.
And having a look at Paris, the number is 70,
which isn't much better.
So, one can say that Berlin's numbers are pretty low in comparison. As a woman, you are 3 to 4 times safer in this city. Still, and it should go without saying, but I've seen it happening too many times not to say it. If you are in a foreign city, don't consume any substances a stranger gives you. One would think that's common sense, but common sense doesn't seem to be so common nowadays.
Next, muggings.
Muggings do happen, but they're not very common. I personally know no one who has ever been mugged here. If you look at the numbers, there are on average 2,500 muggings happening each year. I couldn't find a proper distribution which areas in Berlin are affected the most, but the one that shows up in the media the most is the area around Neulendorfplatz, which is a very popular nightlife hotspot. One thing to worry way more than about being mugged is being pickpocketed, especially if you look like a tourist, their favorite target. More than 14,000 cases have been reported last year, most of which are happening in the area around Alexanderplatz. But really, if you're anywhere in Berlin and it's very crowded, like the public transport for example, you better watch your valuables. Actually, more than half of all criminal offenses are related to theft. And since we're already at the valuables, there's another thing worth protecting we rarely think about, and that is your online presence. Which brings us to today's sponsor, NordVPN. So you know, when you're just browsing some articles to find the best kebab in Berlin, minding your own business, and then BOOM! All those websites, they know what you're looking for, they know where you are, and they know who you are. And that's because your IP address is public. To all of them. It's like the Stasi's wet dream nowadays. And this is exactly why you need a VPN client like NordVPN to hide your IP address. NordVPN is one of the most trustworthy and the fastest provider out there. There's no data logging. I use it almost every day on my computer, on my phone. I'm not even kidding. It's safe, it's fast, and it's just one click away. Here, you can even select the country you want to connect to. Let's go to Australia. Boom! The internet thinks I'm in Australia. Another continent. But do you really need it, you wonder? Well, let's say you're on the hunt for the latest hot NFTs. You don't want some hackers to know where you live and come take them. Or let's say you just want to watch a show that isn't available in your country. NordVPN is going to be your best friend. So if you don't already have it, go to nordvpn.com/radicalliving to get a 2-year plan plus one additional month with a huge discount. And if you're still not sure if you need it, you can try it risk-free for 30 days with a money-back guarantee. You're welcome. Okay, let's move to the safety of your stuff. Should you leave your bike outside? Your car? What about the stuff in your flat? Well, you're not gonna like the numbers. Let's start with the bikes. Everybody has a bike. Everybody needs a bike. It's one of the quickest ways to get around the city. And that's why they are in high demand among thieves. Every year, over 30,000 bikes are stolen in Berlin. That's one bike every 17 minutes. And that are only the reported ones. I didn't even bother reporting my 3 stolen bikes. So imagine how high this number really is. I once watched a German TV show where they made an experiment with that. They took a bike and put it on Kottbusser Tor, which we just saw, put a very cheap lock on it and waited how long it would take for it to be stolen. Well, they didn't have to wait so long. After 45 minutes, it was gone. During the day, that was not at night. So if you get a bike, an expensive bike, don't leave it outside. And if you get a cheap bike, buy a proper lock. They will even steal the crappiest bike on the planet. A lock like this? Don't get it, it's useless. Might as well not lock your bike at all. 5 euro? Waste of money. Something like this is what you need. Costs a few euro more, but you will have a bike. But enough of bikes. What about your car? That thing must be safer than your bike, right? Right? Well, I'm sorry to tell you, but it really isn't. In 2020, there were 4,399 cars stolen in Berlin. That's an average of 94 cars per day. That's a ridiculous number. No wonder you see those huge car locks more and more. And then there's an additional 13,000 cases where parts of the car were stolen. Very popular is the catalyzer, which is made of expensive metals. And another 14,000 cases where stuff from inside the car was taken. Yep, Don't leave your stuff in the car.
But where are all those stolen cars ending up, you wonder?
Well, the police is pretty active in tracking those cars. Many of the cars are being taken apart and shipped to other countries. So they made this map here to show where all of them are being taken. Most of them make their way through Poland to the east, but some even make it to Africa and even Cambodia. And if that wasn't enough, aside from car thefts, you also have to worry about your car being set on fire. Every single day, the firefighters have to head out to extinguish some burning cars here. In 2020, a total of 426 cars were burned on Berlin streets. This map right here shows which districts are affected the most. Cars really don't have a good time here in Berlin. Okay, time to move on to your favorite place, your apartment. Breaking into flats has been trending in Berlin for years. On an average year, over 10,000 break-ins are reported. The winter months are especially popular, since the nights are much longer than in summer. A large number of cases are committed by drug addicts who are looking for quick money for the next fix. But there have been spotted some burglar gangs who even camouflage themselves as moving companies. So take care of your stuff, guys! I actually have a few friends who got their stuff stolen while they were away on Easter holiday or Christmas holiday. So cliché. Just one advice before we move on. In Berlin, there are a lot of old buildings with very similar doors. If you have a door like this, that falls out like that, you should be very careful. You can simply open this door with a hanger in 5 seconds. You can see that someone tried to break in here once using this method. So you gotta tell your landlord to get these extra latches where you can't simply do that. You know? This is what you need. Just this? Your apartment isn't safe at all. Alright, let's get to the serious stuff. Organized crime. This kind of criminal activity is huge in Berlin, but it's nothing the average person will encounter or even should worry about. Berlin's underworld is mostly controlled by 7 Arabian clans. They usually focus on drug trafficking, running brothels and white collar crime. But once in a while, they also do some pretty big heists and armed robberies. Just to give you a few examples, in 2013, they went to the KDW, Berlin's biggest department store, and robbed a jewelry store. In the middle of the day, they got away with accessories worth almost €1 million. In 2017, they stole a 100 kilo gold coin from the Bode Museum, worth almost €4 million. The gold is still missing, by the way. And if you think that your stuff will be safe in a bank's safe deposit box, think again. Those places get taken out so often in Berlin that the media doesn't even bother reporting about it anymore. Every year, one or two of them get taken out. Sometimes they dig tunnels like in the movies. Sometimes they just march in during the day and take what they can. And other times they just bomb the whole bank open. Unfortunately, most of the stolen stuff never turns up again. And the police actually has a very hard time fighting those guys. It's estimated that the clans have over 10,000 members alone in Berlin. That's like a little army. But the authorities are making some progress in fighting them. In 2018, the police confiscated 77 real estate objects from one of the clans, which is probably just a drop on the hot stone, like we say in German, but still, it's better than nothing. There you have it, Berlin at its worst. To sum it up for you quickly, if you're a tourist, beware of pickpocketers. If you live here, try to secure your car and your flat as good as possible. Hope this video gave you a good overview over the state of affairs here. And now I'm curious, what is the worst thing you saw in Berlin that one could call a crime? Let me know in the comments. I'm not sure if I ever saw something serious happen in my 6 years living here. And even though some of the numbers seem pretty frightening, don't worry too much. If you have a little bit of common sense, you should be fine. Just don't go to Kotposator, yeah? I'll be back.